K-I-L-R Taylor Games.
Gamers, simmers, and pilots. I am the Killer Gamer, and welcome to my tour around the world featuring Microsoft Flight Simulator 4. And today should be interesting because the airport that we're going to really doesn't have any navigational beacons or anything that we can use to easily find it. So this is going to be a VFR route. There is actually a way that we can find it, and I'll show you, but we're not going to know how far away it is. That's the thing. So we're going to have to keep our eyes out here. So let's go ahead and show you where it is that we're going. Okay, so here we are at Richard I. Bong. And we're going to be flying along the coast of Lake Superior until we get to here. Not here. Here. Can't zoom in too close. It disappears. So right here, Cornucopia. Cornucopia. It's a private airport. I've called ahead of time. We got permission to land. And why in the world did I choose this airport? I don't know. I just thought the name was interesting. Cornucopia. Kind of made me think of Hunger Games. Not a Hunger Games fan, but I did read the first book. I read the first and second books, actually. Yeah. Did not watch the movies, though. But I saw that and just thought, why not, you know? Little towns interest me. So, you know, I don't want to just keep things to big cities and metropolises and stuff. I want to check out all the little things too. And Cornucopia is a little town. So, I mean, let's go check it out. There just won't be any Sorry, that was my work phone. I'm actually taking time off, and I keep getting this garbage on my work phone about, oh, call us and you can refinance your student loan. I don't have a student loan, so don't call me. All right, let's go ahead and get things started here. That's how it translates to just sputtering into a full-blown, okay, we're all good to go. We'll leave my buildings here. That were supposed to be buildings, not control towers. Some mistakes I'll fix, other ones might be entertaining to... Man, where am I parked here? I'm trying to get turned around. Apparently I don't want to go the way I was going. So let's turn around this way. There we go. I didn't connect that taxiway very well. Now, I'm not sure if the other... runway is this way or not. There are two runways connected by a little curved taxiway. I think this might be the direction, yeah. So we get to use this runway as part of our taxiing. And then we'll use this curved taxiway right here, which will link us to the other runway. Runway 4. All right, that should be good enough. Let's go. We're going to go ahead and set our autopilot at... We'll say 2,000 feet. I think that might be... Or maybe I should do 1,500. I'm not sure. Yeah, let's do 2,000. Let's see. It's on 2,000, so switch it on. Up ahead here is Sky Harbor, not Arizona. This is Sky Harbor, Minnesota. It's like the border of Minnesota and Wisconsin is like, it's like real close around here. Oh no, that's a tower. Okay. So I put this here in the game when I was building the scenery. So yes, you better believe that we are going to be flying here. I didn't put in every single airport. It wouldn't be too hard if you're just plopping down runways. But I have to look up the coordinates of them. And then there's the question of, you know, did I even get the coordinates right? Because the only way that I've been able to find that works somewhat decently is to get the longitude and latitude. Oh, but you know, I just realized that you can enter stuff in this with longitude and latitude, I think. Well, the area that I'm working with is 90% full, so I will need to build a new sectional. Until we can get back to southern Wisconsin. And we're back into the Sublogic scenery discs again. Okay. Well, from here we're set. Now the only thing that we're going to be looking for is a green runway, because it's a turf runway. I just got this email stating that Active Sky is now available for X-Plane. Look at that. Might try putting it up. There we go. Active Sky XP. And Active Sky has got
2 big followers with it.
You have to have an active and stable internet connection. That is required.
Online activation.
But yeah, that should be nice. I don't have any cloud weather programs for X-Plane at the moment. The default version is not bad at all.
Oh, we're out here flying intently. Just south of Lake Superior. Never thought I'd be doing this with Flight Simulator 4. Or playing Flight Simulator 4 at all. My first simulators were Sublogic Flight Simulator 2 and Sublogic Flights for the Commodore 64 and Sublogic Flight Simulator 2 for the Commodore Amiga. Commodore 64 was the very first one. That was on our family computer. But the Commodore Amiga was my computer. It had an Amiga 500. And when I got that, first program I got was Flight Simulator 2. Had to have that on the Amiga. I also got Deluxe Paint. I think it was Deluxe Paint 2. And Deluxe Music Instruction Set. Those were both by EA. Or Electronic Arts. Back when they were called Electronic Arts. And back when they actually put out quality stuff, too. And then I got this other game called Libyans in Space. The Libyans have not won the battle. It was this crazy, two-player shoot-em-up thing in space. And it had these, it was definitely an independent game. And it had sound effects where you blew up a ship and you hear this guy go, and there's like the splash, like a jump in the pool, blowing up another one, and there's like dog sounds. That was not in the game, but I saw it on demo, and I'm like, I gotta get that. I think that's what I got. I also think I've got my original receipt somewhere too. Just our heading over here. I've come to like Flight Simulator 4. This is like flying an improved version of the Amiga with some polygonal textures that you can activate under the sim menu. There's the sounds. The Amiga had the engine sound, but it did not have the landing gear or the flaps. What's interesting is that the sound effects for the gear and the flaps actually continue forward into Flight Simulator 5. Doing some multitasking here, checking out stocks. Stock market is very volatile. Sometimes the best thing to do is nothing when it comes to the stock market. I do a lot of practicing with it using Investopedia. That's pretty decent. It's not overly accurate. I have actual trading software. I don't have anything where you can test it out with. But I log things down on an Excel spreadsheet, and it's like when I buy something on Investopedia with the virtual money, it buys it at a price that is sometimes what it was when I clicked that button, and other times it's not. And that's because there's this delay, like this 15-minute delay before you actually see what it was that you did. So you could buy something at market price, like right now, and then when you go back to your portfolio, it'll just say like you placed an order for it, and it'll be like that for 15 minutes because it's like it refreshes every 15 minutes. So I have to, like, write down the actual prices. If the market's not going very... If it's going sideways, then it's okay. But if it's jumping up and down, you know, then there's a chance that, you know, I bought something at where I wouldn't have bought it originally. I don't know if that made sense or if that just sounded like the ramblings of an old man. I don't know. don't think this is it. It's going to be the same color as this, but... Okay, no, that's not it. Obviously, it would not be sitting on top of this. As a matter of fact, I think that's it right there. Wait. Yep, that's it. Whoa, 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 whoa. Not a very long runway either. I'm not sure what altitude this is at. This could be at 600 or zero. I think it's at 600. Blown off to the side here. See, I put trees and stuff over here. Okay. Let's get turned around and I'll show you around here. So we got some triangle trees. And some round trees. And one tree that is not like the others. And I put a couple of buildings here. And I'll show you the real airport and just kind of show you what I did. I don't know why this happens here. All right. Let's go ahead and take a look at the map view. And there we go. So you can see I've got some trees over here. And then over here I've got a couple of buildings and a couple of trees there. So let's go ahead and take a look at a satellite view of this airport. All right, and this is the satellite view. I don't know why I didn't think about it, but I should have put like two little water things here. I didn't really see them as lakes, so I just didn't think about it. But here are the two buildings. And then obviously I don't have as many trees as what you see here, but I just tried to put some just to kind of give the idea, like, yeah, there's trees over here, there's a little here, there's a little here. So but yeah, this is the actual airport of Konakopia. And that wraps things up for this flight. So I appreciate you hanging out with me and coming with me on this little private tour, I guess you could say, to this private airport, to this little town. And we'll be doing this on the other simulators as well. And with X-Plane, we'll be doing what I always do, a little documentary of us driving into town and seeing what's there. So hope to see you on those. Other than that, thanks for joining me, and I'll see you on the next leg of our journey. Take care. I hope you're enjoying these videos as much as I am making them. They really mean a lot to me, and I'm glad I can share them with you. This same flight can also be seen on these other flight simulators, so they are great if you'd like to make comparisons. If you'd like to see more flight simulator content, then be sure to subscribe to get automatic notifications. There's also that bell thing. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you around. Bring a parachute.